My name is Michael Purzel. I am the Director of Operations and DevOps Engineering at Surescripts. We do two things. We support all the revenue generating environments, so that's our production and staging environments, as well as we deliver a set of tools that lots of other teams build on top of. So that's things like, how do you manage secrets? How do you deploy infrastructure? How do you handle networking? We are known for connecting healthcare. When a doctor needs to send a prescription to a pharmacy, that typically flows through us, as well as lots of different kinds of healthcare data. Our initial challenge was Surescripts is the combination of a couple of merged companies. So we had two gigantic code bases that were trying to be broken apart into microservices. This meant there was lots of service-to-service communication, and historically we had used a classic load balancer, but that was a maintenance nightmare. So we took a look at Consul and having more of a dynamic service registration and discovery workflow. And it delivered value immediately. It was very easy to deploy, and we were able to build some trust that this solved a very concrete problem right away. All of our services, when they're deployed, are registered with Consul. That means every time they're upgraded or a new version is released, that registration is done automatically via our build deploy pipelines. And then beyond that, we also leverage the Consul KV for feature flags. If you want to tweak a particular setting in an application in a dynamic way, we store all that information in the Consul KV. We currently use Packer for producing our golden images. We use Terraform for provisioning all sorts of infrastructure, not just like VMs. We build our environments in GCP. So that's things like PubSub topics and storage buckets, firewall rules. Then we also use Vault for storing secrets as well as for PKI. Yes, you can use each one individually, but if you have a way to store secrets, it only makes sense for those when you have Terraform secrets to store those in Vault, and that very well done integration makes everything work more smoothly. Historically, we stored all of our secrets in configuration files that lived, you know, alongside the application. So anytime we needed to rotate a secret, maybe that secret is leaked or it's just good hygiene, we would have to redeploy every single application. And it was very hard to tell where every instance of that secret would be located. With centralized storage of them in Vault, you know exactly where that secret is. You know exactly how to rotate it. You can identify the blast radius for rotating. I think there's two ways our customers have benefited primarily from HashiCorp tools. The first would be we used to deploy new versions of our application four times a year. We now deploy thousands of times because we can just do so much more. Lots of the HashiCorp tools enabled that kind of thing. We talked a little bit about the networking, but that's also true for how we provision infrastructure, as well as we have a lot of very sensitive data. And Vault allows us to reduce our risk profile and be very careful and deliberate about where we store our secrets. One of the initiatives I'm pushing for 2024 is to implement Consul Service Mesh. We currently only do service discovery and registration in Consul KV. And I think being able to use intention-based security, where the abstraction is application names, not IP addresses that are hard to reason about as a human, will be very good for our security.